This is Puck. Well, today I finally found what I was looking for a long time, and I found it in a state that was really surprising, and I could not let it just stay there and eat dust. I'm kind of addicted these days to certain old phones. We already made a video of the 3GS showing all sorts of fantastic things. I think I should have it here. Where is the thing? Oh, here it is. Look at it. This is a 3GS. And just look at how it looks, man. Look at that. You see that? And it's, even though it's jailbroken, see, yeah, there is the Cydia. You can see it, it's jailbroken. But then again, I made a very beautiful system with not even one reboot, you know. This is a tethered jailbreak, meaning that if you reboot the system, then your Cydia apps won't work, but the rest will still work and the look and feels will stay. I made a video about that long time ago, the SD7, the iOS 7 SD team that you can find in Cydia. It's a fantastic team that will make any old iPhone look like the latest, the newest. You see that? So, you know, we're not gonna talk about the 3GS, but this was just to show you that the 3GS is also in my possession, and it also looks really fantastic. It works good, makes videos, use it as a navigation in the car, use it as a car video, a road video, dash cam video. And well, I'm still looking for the 2G. So if you have a 2G, please send it to me. If you're not doing anything with it, you know, Apple collector here. And today I got the 3G. Here you can see it in the box. So we're gonna open the box so I can show the phone to you. It's in, well, it's not in mint state, as you can see here. You can see it a little bit, the white. You see, but what I'm gonna do with this here, the back, it's really easy. I have a very nice way to kind of lightly, you know, clean this thing really nice up and then give it a glossy coat, and then it looks like new again. Then this all disappears and it becomes glossy again. So we're not gonna talk about the look and feels. It's not a new phone. It's impossible almost to get a new iPhone 3G. I'm sure there are some, you know, still out there being sold, but this is a second-hand phone. It was also a very, very cheap phone, okay, but it works. And I did not install any SIM card, only to activate it. But this is how she looks. This is how the original iPhone 3G came. It was in fact the update of the 2G. And let me show you something here. The video camera can only make pictures. There is no way that you can make a video with this thing. You see that? It makes a beautiful picture for you, and that's what you will have to deal with. And well, Apple at that time was really being criticized about that, because we had other phones, Nokia N95 and, you know, the SPV Orange. They all could, you know, make a video. But then again, the Apple iPhone could not do it, so that was kind of a little bit sad. You know, lots of people were at that time already talking bad about Apple. Apple is overpriced, and Apple this and Apple that. So I give you a little bit of introduction about this phone, the 3G. Okay, what can we do still with a phone like this? Can we run WhatsApp? No, you cannot. You can forget about WhatsApp. Okay, there was a WhatsApp version that used to work. I made a video of that a while ago, but the trick is not working anymore. WhatsApp closed all the, you know, little ditches, and we cannot. So if you're gonna buy an iPhone 3G to, you know, use as a WhatsApp phone, I think that's useless. The iPhone 3G, what can you still do with it? Well, you can let it look just like this phone. It will even look more cute because the guys of the software that we're gonna install. Oh, voicemail. Oops. Stop. It's calling voicemail. Sorry for that. But here you can see it's a big difference, eh? These two. This one is running 4.12. This one is running 6.16. The phones look just the same. It's just the same thing as the iPhone 4 and the 4S. You know, they look the same, but they are in fact not the same. There are some little differences that you will find if you take a good look. You will maybe find something, maybe the serial number at the back, but it won't be the Apple, it won't be buttons, it won't be something special. Only if you turn on the phone, you will see that the 3G cannot film, and this one can film. So, is there still something useful that we could do with this phone? Well, yes. There is a company out there, a software company. It's called White Door. And these guys were out there for many years already, made many videos of them way back, very well watched videos. And these guys, they create a custom ROM. What is a custom ROM? Guys are like, what's a custom ROM? I still have an iPhone 3GS or 3G, but what is a custom ROM? Well, a custom ROM is in fact a ROM that it's the software of the phone, the software that lets the phone start up and will let you do all these things. You know, everything that you see on the phone running, it's called software, and you know, it's created in a, well, developers and users, they call it a ROM. You know, an installer, installer ISO, or that you can use in iTunes, so you can finalize it into a working system. Okay, so this company, White Door, they created at that time software for the iPhone 2G and the 3G. These were guys that, you know, fanatics, and they were like, the 3G must stay alive and we cannot just let it die, and the 2G also not. So they start creating Apple software, you know, and it's fully legal to use it. You know, Apple is even blessing these guys because they also find exploits way back, so they and Apple are friends. You know, Apple is blessing them that they can do a thing like that still for old phones. So the software is called White Door, okay? And White Door is an installer that will make this phone look just like the latest iPhones that we see out there. Of course, it will not have the latest specs, and of course it will not automatically, now because it looks like the iOS 9 or iOS 8, it will not run the apps that, you know, you already understood that when I told you that you cannot run WhatsApp on this thing anymore. You know, then you understand that this phone will, of course, even though it's gonna look like a very beautiful iPhone 7 or 6, 5, 4, you know, it will still stay the 3, okay? All right, good. So you understand that. What will happen when we're gonna put the software on this phone? Well, the way to install the software on this phone is to put this phone into a pound DFU mode. And a pound DFU you can reach thanks to a tool called Red Snow. It's also included in the package. You have the IPSW, the restore software, the ROM, and you also have a tool called, it's a jailbreaking tool, a tool called Red Snow. It's a special version, by the way, very old version for this phone only. You will find it in the description of my download link, and you will download a RAR file that you can unpack, and then you will have, you know, a folder with all the tools inside that you need to do this. You will also need a computer running Mac or Windows. So Mac and Windows users can do this, but that is already known from Apple. Apple supports both, thanks to iTunes, and of course, thanks to Red Snow in the both versions, Windows and Mac OS X. Okay, so you got a lot of information, so you kind of understand how it is with this phone. It's still a beautiful phone. It feels very solid. It's heavy. You know, you don't want to let it fall on the ground, especially not on bare stone. It will break, you know, and then, you know, it's sad because you then broke something of the past that one day will have a fantastic value. Just letting you know. All right, good. So we have the RAM, we have a computer with iTunes, yeah, and the first thing that we gonna do is we gonna turn off the phone. We press the power and click, we turn it off. Now we will have to put the phone into a DFU mode. So what is a DFU mode? Well, a DFU mode is in fact a deep sleep for the iPhone 3GS. You will put your phone in a kind of narcose. I call it narcose. So when you go to the hospital, you know, and you must do surgery, they must do a surgery on you, then probably you will get or an injection and then you fall asleep, or you get a mask, you know, with gas, and then, you know, you will fall asleep immediately because of that gas. And when you're in that sleep, you are way more accessible to do a surgery, because that is in fact also what we're gonna do on this phone. This phone will get a surgery by the software of White Door. Okay, we will have to put it into a DFU mode. How do we put the phone into a DFU mode? In fact, it's really easy. You're gonna hold down the home button and then you're gonna press the power, and you're gonna hold the power until the Apple logo disappears. After 2 seconds, you let go of the power, but you keep holding the home button. Okay, so at this point, yeah, this phone now is in DFU mode. Okay, this phone is now in a very deep sleep. And how will we know? Well, if we connect this phone to the USB, if it was not in a DFU mode, the Apple logo is popping up, so it was not in a good DFU mode. Shall we do it again? Okay, so we hold down both. We're just gonna do it a professional way now. We hold both down until the logo disappears. We let go of the power and then we press the power again, holding the home button. So we're gonna see the Apple logo. We hold it until the Apple logo disappears. 1, 2, let go of the power button, keep holding the home button. And now, if everything goes right, then your iTunes will say that it found a phone that needs to be fixed. Sorry for that. And let me open iTunes. Let me see if that is really the case. Yes. It's saying, no, I must remove the iPhone 6. No, not the iPhone. This is the iPhone 3. I must remove the iPhone 6. So it's saying iTunes has detected the iPhone in the recovery mode. You must restore this iPhone before it can be used with iTunes. So what is it saying there? It's saying that this phone is being detected in a DFU mode. And let's take a look at that. Here you can see it. It's saying iTunes has detected the iPhone in recovery mode, because that is what this phone is in now. The recovery mode, you know, the surgery mode, that is what it's in right now. You know, it's black, screen is black, no, there's no sign of life. You know, the thing is in a deep sleep, but you can see iTunes, the doctors can see that, you know, there's a heartbeat there and, you know, there's a phone there that is very ill or need to be fixed, okay? In this case, it will not be fixed, it will be updated. Updated to a special version of the iOS, so it will, you know, get different look and feels. Okay, so here you can see the folder that I got. iPhone 3G, and there is the folder. It's saying a white door. Can you read it? I think you could read it. Huh? And when we open the folder white door, we will see that I have a little pineapple there, and that is Red Snow. Please start up Red Snow. Give permission to start. Windows will also ask. And here you will see that the iPhone 3G is in a what the fuck mode. And to tell you the truth, I know that is not good. Okay, so we're gonna put it in a pound DFU mode. So, and as you can see, it's not doing anything because it's in a what the fuck mode. And you guys are like, what is a what the fuck mode? Well, to tell you the truth, that is a mode that is not good enough for the phone to be fixed. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna hold power, we're gonna get it out of the what the fuck mode, and now we're gonna say power on, wait for the Apple, we hold down the home button, we keep holding them both until the logo disappears. 1, 2, we let go of this one. About the what the fuck DFU mode, it's very important that the phone is correctly set into DFU, and if that is not the case, then you know this won't work and you will see this phone is connected in a what the fuck DFU mode. So make sure that your phone is correctly into a DFU mode so you don't have that warning there under in Red Snow. You can try it again with your iTunes open. Make sure that the cable is connected to the phone, so when you are kind of in DFU mode and then start up Red Snow again, you know, you will see that the phone is in a correct DFU mode. Also, iTunes will pop up saying that it found an iPhone that need to be restored. Most of the times then the phone is in the right DFU mode, but sometimes it's also not, because just now iTunes said that it found a phone that need to be restored, but in Red Snow we got what the fuck mode. So we need to fix that. You really need to fix that. Until you didn't, if you cannot pass that part, you will not even able to do this. So you must make sure that your phone is in a correct DFU mode. There are little apps that you could download. I will look some up. I did not use them. I do it manually, but there are some apps that will put your phone into a DFU mode, and then from there you know, Red Snow will take it over and do the injections, so you can go into a pound DFU mode, so iTunes, you know, won't go checking with Apple if it's okay to downgrade or whatsoever. It will just accept the ROM and start downgrading. Well, downgrading, it's effect upgrade, it's a D upgrader, it's a D upgrade. A D upgrade means a downgrade that brings upgrades, and you will be amazed of the things that this phone will be able to do. You will have a free navigator, TomTom. You will have a free app store with all apps working in there. You won't have WhatsApp, so you know, we already spoke about that, but most things you will be able to do. I'm listening to reggae music with mine at this moment. It's fantastic after navigating with TomTom. So let's go back to the video. Okay, so we are now in DFU mode, all right? We're just gonna quit this, because the iPhone is also wanting to, you know? So we're gonna go to Extras, and we're gonna say pound DFU. Waiting for a reboot, done. You see that? Now it's in the pound DFU mode. PWNED DFU mode. So it's saying done there. So I should be able to point iTunes to this white door software. And that's what we're gonna do now. There are two white door softwares. So in fact, this video is also will also learn you how to, you know, unlock every 3G that is locked to some provider, you know, you don't have a SIM card for it. You know, if you want to use every SIM card, then you must do this, what I'm showing you now. So we're gonna go to the iPhone, to the iPhone 3G. There it is, beautiful. We're gonna hit the Alt and then the Restore. With the Windows computers, it's Shift, okay? We're gonna go to our desktop and then we're gonna look for the folder of the iPhone 3G. There it is, white door. Okay, you see it? And here is the software. We're gonna point to it and iTunes is extracting the software. And now it's gonna contact Apple. Restoring iPhone. There you can see the white screen of the iPhone is popping up. And there is the Apple. And now it's gonna install a very, very fantastic, fantastic updated iOS. I will call this video how to get iOS, how to get the latest iOS L and F look and feels on your old iPhone 3G. So yeah, that's what this video in fact is about, you know, making this old phone look like one of them latest, you know, phones, having all these, you know, little beautiful colors and icons, you know, so you don't have the feeling that you're kind of using a very old device. Okay, so that in fact is the whole meaning of this, because I mean, let's be honest, having an iPhone 3G that cannot even create a small video, that is, you know, not so fantastic. Very soon we're also gonna make a drive, you know, it can be with a car or with a bike, and then we're gonna mount this 3G, and then we're gonna make a video recording, a road video, you know, leaving the cam nice and quiet in a tripod, and then, you know, we're gonna make a nice video. And then you will see what you can still do with the iPhone 3G. And then you can say, hey, I already have a cool phone. I have the iPhone 7. I have whatever, the 6S Plus, whatever you have. You know, why should you even bother? Well, this video is also not for you guys. This video, in fact, is more for people that, you know, even will get more curious of what they see in this video and probably will go ahead and start looking on eBay or those marketplaces that we have on Facebook just to, you know, find a device that will kind of give them this possibility to kind of play around, you know. And a device like that, you know, can be up to the iPhone 4G. Okay, because let's be honest, iPhone 4S running iOS 9 point whatever 3.2, that is, you know, not what you want, because you can never go back, you know. These phones are the only phones that you can downgrade, the 3G and the 3GS. In my previous video I showed you how to downgrade to iOS 4.1 from 6.16, overcoming the error 1025, was it, or 1015? I can't even remember the damn error. But we get the error and we need to fix that, and we need to get the thing out of recovery, etc., etc., you know, to downgrade. I did it, and I did it successfully. But still, if you're on 4.1, then in fact with the 3GS, it's like, you know, somebody's offering you a nice house to live in and then you say, no, I want to stay in my little cabin, you know. That is crazy. So, you know, a 3GS should really run, you know, at least iOS 5.11, but if it's running 6.16, then yeah, you're good to go, because you can run Facebook, you can run all these WhatsApp things, apps, you know. So yeah, and if you're kind of bothered by the old look and feels, then of course you can, you know, do this what I showed you with the 3GS. Get this look and feels, you know, these look and feels, they give you the idea that you're having a complete new phone. and it looks very good. And these new Apple users, some of them, they really don't know nothing. They don't even have iTunes. They just have an iPhone because of the little Apple at the back that is kind of giving them the feeling that life is treating them good. At least that was how it was. It's like the Mercedes Benz, you know, it has a star when you drive in your Mercedes. I also had Mercedes, you know, at a certain moment when I traded my Mercedes for a BMW, you know, that night I felt so bad that I, you know, cause something was wrong with my Mercedes. And in fact, yeah, I had to, you know, it was a good trade, you know, against the BMW. But then I felt so sad cause the BMW was so boring. There was no star in the front. It was not letting me feel as if, you know, I am successful in life. Because that is exactly what this star and this little apple is doing to the people. Eh? The star is letting the drivers feel as, you know, as if life is treating them very well. You know, that's why, you know, they feel as a king on the road. Because that is how a Mercedes makes you feel when you drive in them. And that's the same thing with the iPhone. You know, using an iPhone, the weight of the iPhone, the way it feels, especially... you know, well, all the devices, they are not, you know, an iPhone is having a totally different weight than a Samsung phone. Samsung phone is way lighter, although, hey, make no mistake, these Samsung phones, they are also very, very good, and make no mistake, no bad word about Samsung, except for that they, you know, steal from the ones that was placing the biggest deals at them. And started their own little, you know, thing, and you know, many law cases also passed through the lines, Apple, Samsung. But then others also say, yeah, Apple also stole the blah blah blah. So yeah, but still Apple, yeah, Apple and Samsung. Yeah, what can I say? I trust Apple even more than Samsung, because yeah, Samsung is coming from a country that is not a Western country, so you never know what these people are doing. And if we know that the Chinese have the most powerful computer on earth, then we know that our friends from eastern parts of the world, they are like aliens. They are very smart people, you know, fantastic and smart people. So yeah, they could do everything to us, you know, if it comes up to, you know, techniques and phones and, you know, Samsung with all their bloody apps they install, and nobody's even using the apps, but nobody's complaining about them. Everybody just play hypocrite. So okay, here we are, and this is how it looks, peeps. We are in. I'm gonna put the phone a little bit like this. I hope you can see it. I must say, need insert valid SIM with no SIM lock. Okay, so we must insert a valid SIM with no SIM lock. And now, of course, I cannot find my little PIN. So I'll be right back. Okay, I found it. I also have a SIM, and this SIM, I want to thank my friends from Albert Heijn. This is a SIM from Albert Heijn Mobile, and the guy gifted to me completely free. And I was asking for a Lebara, the free SIM cards. Here in the Netherlands, we can get free SIMs. There's a company named Lebara, and they are giving out free SIMs. And if your phone is kind of not SIM locked, then you can get a SIM and just put some money on the account. And then, you know, you will be good to go. We're sorry, we're unable to continue your activation at the stand. Well, blah, blah, blah. So we're gonna do it again. We removed the cable and popped it in again. And we already see the beautiful look and feels, eh? We already see it, iPhone. And we will be activated in every second from now. And we are activated. And here you can see, and we can immediately see that the original, because I'm going to show you the original. This is how it looks. Your phone has been unlocked. This may take some time waiting for activation, but this is the original lock screen, and it's been unlocked now. We were already unlocked. Oh, look at that. And here you can see that we will not have the fancy round dialers, because this phone is now booted in the tethered mode, meaning Cydia apps are not working, and the only thing that is working are the look and feels. So that is more than enough to me, you know, because in fact, yeah, I don't need anything from Cydia, only this theme, nothing more. Okay, and the 7SD theme is installed, and now I boot it in the normal way again, and I have my app store to get my, you know, my Apple apps. In fact, I'm never, you know, downloading apps. I'm only doing tricks, you know, to make the system look, or, you know, give it the extra functionality. So let's look at the desktop. Wow, look at that. This is the 3G, peeps. Make no mistake. This was the one that could not film. And let me see, can we film now? Here you can see that now we even don't allow. Here we even have a little slider that can let us select a video. If we can select it. There we go. And it's the side order. And we could also install all these things manually, peeps. And let's make a little recording. I think we must press there. Okay, we're recording. Hello, this is Puck, and we are recording with the sidecorder of the 3G, making a review, and we just installed the White Door software. So yeah, we're making a test, so let's see how this looks. So we're turning the cam, we're stopping the recording, and now we're gonna look for the recording. We just hit play, and there is the recording.
The sidecorder of the 3G, making a review, and we just installed the White Door software. So yeah, we're making a test, so let's see how this looks.
The recording is made in 640 by 480, at least that is what I think. I think, and we have Cydia, peeps. You see that we have Cydia. This is an untethered Jailbreak, in fact. This ROM is untethered. We even have YouTube. We have the brand new apps. Do we have the pull-up menu? No, the pull-up menu is not there. Do we have it in the start menu here? No. Okay, here we have no cam. So maybe we can still set that up here somewhere. In maybe, oh, look at that. Wow, 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 wow. Look at that. I'm gonna get my iPhone 6 here, so we can take a look together at, where is my bloody phone? Oh yeah, it's filming. Don't I have another? Oh yeah, I can take this one. So okay, this is the very big brother. This is the very big brother of the iPhone 3G. Yeah. And let's go to the settings. We hit settings, and look at that. Wow, wow, this is almost the same, peeps. It's really hard to hold two phones in your hand like this, but there you go. You see that? It's maybe not so smooth. Well, it's pretty smooth enough. Nobody should complain about this. This looks fantastic. So I want to give my my respect and my thanks, of course, to nobody else than my friends of White Door. Well done, my friends. This looks really just like the real thing, and I can say it because I have the real thing, and this is, of course, also a real thing. Look at these wallpapers. wow. You can immediately give this thing the same look and feels. Look at that. Wow. Jonge, wat is dit prachtig zeg. We set this as the home screen. I was saying, what is this beautiful, eh? What is it beautiful? Applying wallpaper. So there we go. Now we're gonna take a wallpaper for the lock screen. I think the lock screen should be very colorful. It's so wow, look at that. So there we go. We're gonna go to the lock screen. Of course, I must remove this, the power to see. And we are 100% charged. This is what you will get in return, peeps, with the wide door software on your iPhone 3G. And if we go to look at the settings of this phone, what it is, in fact, and then we will see that this is that this is iOS 3.13, so we downgraded from 4.21. So this is also how to downgrade your iPhone 3G on 4.2.1 to 3.13, but then with iOS 7 or maybe even 9 look and feels. Here it is. This is what you were looking for. And look at this, this dock. The dock also looks really nice. I never get the dock so beautiful. I always, my dock is never so nice when I do this teaming as well. So I think these guys use a way better method than I'm using on the 3GS. This one here, because in fact, if we take a look at them, we will see that, yeah, in some way. Hey, wait a minute. Do you see something, peeps? Where's my wallpaper? I don't see no wallpaper. Wallpaper. Let's put the wallpaper. I thought I set this one. And I wanted to set it as the home screen. Applying this wallpaper may take a minute. Okay. But it's not applying. And why is it not applying? Well, that is an old trick. That's because this device needs to be restarted. So we're gonna turn it off. And we're gonna take a look at the real-time boot of this thing. Okie doke. So we're gonna turn the baby on. Press the power on. Remember not to press these buttons too hard. Eh? Be nice to them. You know, try to feel the way they go in. And, you know, don't press them too hard. Don't break them. It's an old device. You must be nice to this device. This is a quality device that costed a lot of money at that time. And is still a fantastic device. Only, you know, we are so bloody spoiled that we don't see it anymore. We don't know anymore. We just have one lying around. And we're doing crazy things with our private phones. You know, that while this thing could still help out. And there you can see. There is your wallpaper. We slide to unlock. And there is your wallpaper. Is it amazing or is it amazing? So the only thing of this phone is, yeah, it should get a little bit glossy. Here there is a crack. You see that? I probably, yeah, this is a crack. I think this thing felt on the ground. I don't know if it's a real crack. Or if it's a scratch. I think it's a... It feels like a crack. So I will have to fix this as well. Just to give it a, you know. And then... Of course, this must be masked off really good. Because we're not gonna do the sides. At least this part here. Will not be done, and most of the time the sides just look fine. You see, it's the back that is getting kinda, yeah. So peeps, what do you say? Was this not a beautiful project on the late Saturday night? I think it was a beautiful project, and I'm really happy with this iPhone 3G. Oh, look at that! After the reboot, we also got the pull-up menu. Wow, wide door. I never saw that, baby. Look at what you guys and girls fixed us. I think the 3GS and the iPhone 3G are two phones, peeps, that we can still use on a daily basis. And when I say daily basis, I'm not saying that you should go do banking with this thing, but I mean, like, on daily basis, you could maybe do banking, but I'm not sure if the browser will let you do that, you know, because most of the times these browsers are, well, I'm not sure, because this phone, qua ROM, it's downgraded to 3.13. But then again, this is the true meaning of an update. The phone became more beautiful, it became faster, and it can do more. You can now also create videos, as you could see. Pretty good video, 640 480, but it's just fine, you know. So yeah, I think that wide door understands the true meaning of updating, and that is with just a little ping to, you know, all these big companies updating and, you know, creating software systems for the people, the users, and the users are like scratching their head. They're like, hey, I used to know this thing, and now I don't understand anything. I don't even know how to change my damn wallpaper. And they start throwing with tablets and with computers, and they're begging their administrators to, you know, get the operating system that they understand back to their computers. So in fact, yeah, this is, you know, the past, the future, you know, past and future of Apple are combined in this thing. You know, it's beautiful, it looks really good, the colors of the icons, they look fantastic. It's really a beautiful phone. I'm not sure if you can see the deepness and the shine on the, it's just beautiful. So wide door, I want to thank you for this beautiful ROM that you created for us. Also, all the time and effort that you put into this for so many years. I see, you know, yesterday I was busy with this iPhone 2G. I have a 2G here. Video is still coming up from the thing. It's bricked. In fact, I fixed it, upgraded it, but in fact, battery life is useless since it's on iOS 4 point, whatever it is. Because, yeah, battery is, a full battery will go in one night. It's then empty. It needs to be charged again. As you can see, it's empty. Also having the same look and feels. I was looking for slim ROM, and slim ROM is, I think, Android slim. So I went to into my video list and, you know, went some years back in time and looked for the slim bean ROM, and I went to the site and there's no download anymore. Everything is, you know, I mean, like, that's sad, you know. When I see things like that, then I find that sad. But wide door kept going on. They, you know, kept their belief and kept working on this, and even got us the latest look and feels for our old device, our old 3G, you know. And thanks to the boys, of course, of all the teams that are available in Cydia. You know, we can also get the 3GS looking just as fine, you know. So and if we had the 2G, with the 2G we could do the same. The 2G could look just like this. So in fact, all Apple devices, you know, that were created, all iPhones that were created until now, can have the same look and feels. Well, yeah, the same look and feels. But of course, the new ones will have extra little whatever thingies and more power and more this and more that. But in fact, it's the same phone. I hope you enjoyed this video of the 3G. I really enjoyed it to make it. As you could hear, I spoke a lot. And yeah, it's just an old phone. If you're lucky, you can also find it for 10 euros, you know. And then, yeah, you can do these crazy things with it. And the feeling that you will get when it's done is really amazing. And yeah, you won't be playing with your expensive phone. It will just stay there for future purposes, you know. When that phone get old again, then you're gonna start playing with the iPhone 6, like, really, oh wow, what a cool phone, such an old phone, and look how beautiful it is, wow, this is amazing, you know. And that is how I feel about this phone and the 3GS at this moment. So I want to thank you again, once again, for watching. I hope you like this video. I'm kind of addicted these last days. I'm seeing on marketplace, you know, all sorts of phones are being sold really cheap, you know, 10 bucks, 15 bucks, 20 bucks. In fact, I paid 20 bucks for this Samsung S2, but the boy lied a little bit to me. I asked him if the cam were good, you know, but he didn't tell me about this cam. If you take a good look, you can see that the whole top here is scratched. So I must go get a new one of this, but I'm not gonna do it. The front cam, the selfie cam is just fine. You know, I'm not gonna fix this thing. This thing, I'm gonna make a tablet of it, because it can also not read the SIM cards. So, you know, with some routing software, I will just remove the phone app and the message app there. And then this thing will become a 5-inch, what is it? 4.something inch tablet, you know. So that's it, it's no big deal. So, spoken of, I'm very thirsty now. I'm gonna get myself, hey, I still have, of course, I always, when I, you know, always get myself something to drink. That is something that is mandatory to do. You must have something relaxing beside you so you don't get stressy, because when you get stressy, these phones, they also feel your stress. And maybe you don't understand why that is, but I'm gonna show you and tell you, explain it to you why. This is an electrical device, but our body is also an electrical device. You know, haven't you feel sometimes when you somebody that is really crazy, you know, he wants to kill people, when you get in his neighborhood, that you feel a strange electricity going? That is his electricity, because he's, you know, so pissed and mad. And when you're pissed and mad, then that energy of your body, you know, it's an energy that we don't understand. It's electric energy that we don't really understand. It's way too beyond for us to understand. But these devices, they feel that, you know. And you can break a device if you're in a bad mood, if you're in a bad, you know, if you have a bad karma around you at that moment, you know, if you're pissed off somebody that you're hating, whatever. Pissed off, you know, you want to kill the device, you know, that is, you know, that will also have effect on your electrical devices. Maybe you just take the television and throw it out of the window, or maybe the thing will out of itself when you're doing some DFU installer, you install, you know, it will feel that negative electricity from your body and it will go straight into the device, you know, because you're also working and touching your MacBook, and that energy is going straight to there, and boom, your whole MacBook starts to get errors and the phone, you know, the whole thing went wrong and the phone is bricked for life. Things like that happen. It happened to me in the past, that's why I'm telling you. So you must always be calm when you do things like this. Alright? Then I want to wish you good luck. Of course, I'm not responsible if you're breaking your device because you were pressing the buttons too hard, or you got pissed and you threw the phone against the wall. That is all for your risk. But I advise you not to do these things. Just stay calm, just like me. Get some coffee or some tea, some chocolate milk, you know, and relax yourself. and have a fine job there with your old iPhone 3G. It's worth it. It's really worth it. And I'm really happy that I have it in my possession. So once again, thank you for watching. If you like this video, give it a like. Of course, subscribe to my channel, because I have, I think, 1500 something videos open for the public. In fact, I have 1600 videos. When I look at my video list, I have 1600, but many of them I also, you know, I just put them on private, because probably they were doing so bad that they had to, you know, go on private instead of embarrassing me with these low views. So peeps, once again, I'm not gonna make this video any longer. Enjoy your iPhone 3G. It's worth it. If you still have one, if you still have the box, you know, be very nice to it and honor it, because one day it's gonna, you know, make you a little fortune, the same thing that you're looking at. And if you're young and you have a thing like this, then you still have a long life, and then you will think that this thing is useless. But trust me, if you put it away nice, you cleaned it and save it for 10 or 15 or 20, 30 years, in 30 years from now, you know, the same phone will, you know, it will be a collector's item, 100%, for real. The 2G is already a collector's item. It's not for, you know, some idiot is selling one for 200 bucks here on Marketplace. The same 2G, the 2G, the little brother of this one. So make no mistake, these phones, they are collector's items. And if you can buy them cheap on the Marketplace, you know, I would go ahead and just start your collection. iPhones, I have the 3G, the 3GS, the 4, the 4S. I don't have the 5, none of the 5, the 6 and the 6 Plus. In fact, these are the iPhones that I own, and and I'm really happy with them. And once in a while I get them out of their, I call it the golden case, and then, you know, I have some project or some video that I want to do with them. So in fact, these things, they are my actors and actresses. These are my Hollywood stars, you see. And soon, if my cousin is gonna keep his promise, I will get the SPV, and that was my first smartphone ever, the SPV Orange. Yes, sir, the SPV Orange. And here you can see it. This was my first smartphone. Yeah, the thing could connect to the internet via Active Sync, via a computer that was also connected to the internet. You could get on MSN, you could chat on MSN. And the thing had a little cam that you could plug in at the backside. You know, it was like a little add-on, a hardware add-on cam. And then you could also create a little video and make pictures. So this thing, it had Explorer. It was, in fact, the first smartphone. And it was really, really fantastic. And I'm gonna get it from my cousin. He still have one in mint state. It's like brand new, cause he never used it. He found it too big when he got it. He played a bit with it, but he never really used it. He put it away and used his own small Nokia. You know, that's how people were before. They didn't want this. So he probably saw the MSN logo in the advertisement of the phone. It looked really attractive at that time. It looked really fantastic, a phone that could connect to the internet. And you know, the thing don't even have Wi-Fi, you know, and the 3G connection was not there at that time. At that time we had Edge, you know, we had 56k over the phone. It was not, or was it 56k? I think that was it. There was a modem in the phone, you know, you could only contact via the normal, via your SIM card. We didn't have no 3G connection at that time. Or maybe we did, but it was not available for us. So yeah, that was it. Every time I remember something again of the devices, and then, you know, I start talking again. That while this video had to be over a long time already, so I must really stop it now. So goodbye, have yourself a beautiful Sunday, or Yeah, in fact, it's already Sunday. Have yourself a beautiful week. I think that's better. Have yourself a nice week and be nice to your friends, family, and your old phones out there. And maybe you will feel the glory that I also feel by making these things so beautiful and so fantastic.